Hi, I'm Dr. Ron Miller with Pursuit Physiotherapy, and today we're going to really go over what is lactic acid and what is that soreness in your muscle that you get 1 or 2 days later. So first off, what really is it? So that soreness that you get in your muscles from either your workout or your run, that soreness in the muscle 1 to 2 days later is not lactic acid buildup. That is something that's called DOMS, or delayed onset muscle soreness. And what that is just from the exercise, you have some muscle breakdown and it causes some soreness. And that's a good thing, because when your muscle breaks down with rest, you start to recover, and that's how a muscle gets stronger or adapts to the exercise. So that muscle soreness 1 to 2 days after your workout is not lactic acid buildup. That's actually muscle, you know, breakdown or muscle soreness from the actual exercise. So then what is all this lactic acid talk? Okay, not to get too scientific, but lactic acid is just a byproduct of when your muscle uses sugar or glycogen for energy, okay? So I don't wanna get into like the specifics of it too much, but lactic acid is just a byproduct of glycolysis, or when your muscle uses sugar or glycogen for exercise. And there's different types of things, whether you want to get into short term versus 1 to 3 minutes versus long term and using fats. But let's just keep it simple. So when you're exercising, you know, and your body is using sugar for its primary source of energy, it can only handle so much. And when you cross that threshold, you know, and it's using sugar too much, you get this lactic acid buildup. And it creates an environment for that muscle that it can't function properly. And then you start getting that muscle burn. If you keep using that same system, you know, using sugar for your source of energy, then lactic acid builds up, and then you start to get fatigued because your muscle can't work properly in that environment. So when you use sugar too much for it, you know, normally it's like 1 to 3 minute bursts, or if you're training too hard, too fast, you get the muscle burning faster. You know, you can't produce or perform at that level. Then you get lactic acid buildup, the muscles burn, and you reach fatigue, and then you have to stop. Okay, that burning in your muscle is lactic acid. So let's use a few examples. Say you're in the gym, you have a lighter weight, and you're just doing bicep curls, and you're doing reps of 15, 20, and 25. As you're doing that bicep curl, that muscle burn, that's lactic acid buildup. Okay, say you're running right now and you're pushing yourself. Say you're comfortable at running like a 7 minute mile pace, and say you take off running at like a 5:30 minute mile pace. You know, you can't sustain that for long periods of time because you're going to be tapping into those sugar storage or the muscle glycogen for that. If you run at that fast pace but you're not ready for that, you're going to reach fatigue fast. Okay, and when you start running at that fast pace and you feel the muscle burning in your legs and your quads and your calves, that's lactic acid buildup, because you're running too fast and that lactic acid's building up, and you're gonna reach fatigue, you're gonna feel the muscle burn, and you can't perform at that level for long periods of time because it's meant to just give you short bursts of energy up to 3 minutes long. Some of the research says it's very gray, it's not black and white. But that's what lactic acid buildup really is when you do an exercise too much too fast and you reach that point of fatigue, and then your muscles break down and you can't perform and you have to stop. So that's the difference between the muscle soreness that you get 1 to 2 days after the workout versus true lactic acid buildup. Okay, now, can you prevent lactic acid from building up? And the answer is yes. It's really yes and no. If you just push yourself really hard, you're always going to reach that threshold and you're going to, you know, get lactic acid buildup, the muscle burning. But with time and with training and exercise, your muscle will adapt to be able to perform that exercise at a more efficient level, to, you know, adapt to your training methods to be able to prevent lactic acid from building up to the point where you get fatigued, or that threshold with training starts to go up like this. You can tolerate more, train harder without reaching that threshold. A lot of people use this strategy if you're running a, say you're a novice runner, you're just starting to run. Yeah, you're gonna get that lactic acid buildup as you're doing a run or like a race. But after 2 months of training, if you do that same run or that same race at that same tempo, your body's gonna be adapted, your muscles are gonna be stronger, more efficient, that same race 2 months later isn't gonna cause that lactic acid fatigue. I remember when I was running a 10K once, my goal was to run a sub 40 minute 10K. So I started off the race and I took off and I was running at a very fast rate. And I noticed that, you know, my quads started to get fatigued and I had to ask myself, okay, do I want to keep this pace up, but I'm going to fatigue and then start running really slow, or to be able to withstand the race for the 6 miles, should I back off of my pace a little bit, stay underneath my threshold so I don't ever reach that lactic acid buildup, and then be able to consistently stay at that same faster pace, but not to a point where I'm reaching fatigue or reaching that lactic acid buildup. So in a race, it's a great example of, if you're running a race and you're starting to feel that lactic acid buildup and the muscles fatiguing and the burning, you gotta back off your pace a little bit or you're gonna reach that threshold and you're gonna be fatigued. So you have to back off, slow it down just a little bit, just below that threshold, so you can optimally run as fast as you can without crossing that threshold, and then you'll stay comfortable with that. But in the long term, yes, you can help, you know, your body's gonna adapt with training, with strengthening, with endurance training, interval training. Your body and your muscles will adapt to become more efficient, stronger, and better equipped to prevent fatigue from occurring, and thus you should notice a difference month to month to month that same exercise or that same distance of running doesn't cause the lactic acid buildup or that fatigue or that or your threshold's low compared to after months of training. So yes, it can be prevented with proper training, adaptation to exercise and stuff like that. So I hope this clears up a little bit about lactic acid, what DOMS is, what is that soreness, what's the best way to help prevent it, you know. If you have any other questions, please, you can send us an email at pursuittherapy@gmail.com. Please subscribe to the YouTube channel. We have running playlists. We have a lot of educational content out there, or you can even follow us on Facebook. So thanks for tuning in. I hope you learned something here. And until next time, I'll see you soon.